Joining us now to answer your tax questions is our friend Tony King of King, King & Associates. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
All right, how are things going so far with tax season?
Right now it has not picked up.
It hasn't picked up yet.
But give us another few days.
So you still have a life.
Yes.
But not for much longer.
And right now it's not really tax season. It's Super Bowl Sunday.
It is. Well, maybe that this question is kind of related to that, if I can, because our first question has to do with, if I can go there, I know I'm making a link here, so just bear with me. Don't write me emails. Are Alcoholics Anonymous expenses tax deductible is the question.
Interesting.
Don't you think so? Yeah.
There are very addiction-related expenses are treated as medical expenses, mm-hmm. but keep in mind that medical expenses are only deductible if you qualify to use Schedule A, itemized deductions. And then on top of that, all medical expenses are limited to 10% of your gross income. So if somebody makes $50,000 a year, the first $5,000 of medical-related expenses are not deductible.
Okay, so for a yes or no answer, what's
yes?
Thank you. All right. Okay. Second question. I work at a hospital. This is such a great question. I'm an essential employee, and during the snowstorm, I stayed in a hotel. Can my hotel bill and food paid during the storm be utilized as a tax deduction? I'm thinking yes.
You're thinking correct.
Yay!
Again, those would be recognized as employee, unreimbursed employee expenses.
Yeah, sure.
But similar to medical expenses, they are limited to 2% of your adjusted gross income.
Okay.
And you also must deduct those expenses on Form 2106. And then those expenses then follow through Schedule A itemized deductions.
And obviously you'd need your receipts for that.
Yes.
Okay. And then we also have a question. I got a letter from Social Security and it said that I might have to pay taxes on the $5,000 they gave me. Nobody gives you nothing. Could this be true?
Yes, it could be. Social Security benefits are generally taxable, but if the $5,000 is the only source of income, then those benefits would not be taxable. Social Security benefits are sometimes taxable when combined with other income. If they exceed a certain threshold, then they are taxable. But in this case, if the $5,000 was the only source of income, then that would not be taxable.
Okay, 30 seconds left. Last question. My husband and I were victims of tax-related identity theft last year. Mm. We received a federal PIN. Are we able to file through TurboTax, or do we still need to file paper returns?
You still can do e-file with your PIN, but just keep in mind that that PIN must be correct and it must be attached to the electronic signature, the electronic tax return. You can't use that PIN to sign your return electronically.
Okay.
But once the IRS gives you that PIN, you still can e-file.
Okay, wow. All right, these were great questions. We appreciate you coming in.
Thank you.
So if we didn't get to your question this morning, we will answer it next week. Keep them coming. You can email your tax questions directly to taxquestions@WBALTV.com or go to our website, WBALTV.com, and click on Consumer Alert.